wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, we are from group 10. I am Anissa Ramawati and here I am with my partner Azira and Lila Ceslia. Today we will presentation about essence and foundation of human communication, an ethical response in an age of absurdity. According to Camus, the absurdity represents a state that arises in humans between the human need for clarity and the fact that sometimes life makes no sense. When a person is caught in this absurd situation, the best option is to rebel against the situation and create meaning in life by himself. The theory of the background from the absurdity informs all of Camus' involvement with moments in his history. Rebellion, for Camus, was an act against time that made no sense and represented an attempt to impose order in a chaotic world. The unity of contraries. Reality is a term used to describe the way in which the world is experienced and visible to humans. There is truth and world experience. For example, even though a person may experience chaos in his daily life or reality, he can still be comforted by the fact that God is in control of everything or truth. Metaphysical rebellion extends consciousness throughout experience. Absurdity is a phenomenological reality. Human responses and engagement with that reality represents hermeneutic changes or meaning interpretation. Responding through existential rebellion can reveal that the rebellion itself can be an entry point to something else. Three forms of written communication from Camus. There is philosophical essays, novels, and plays. Narrative engagement. Camus provides a physical example through his character's response to the plague of an appropriate expression of rebellion. The fundamental contradiction of human existence and provides a connecting point between the plague and the project. The plague is an ethical response to rebellion. After Oren is quarantined, the characters in the novel are caught between two choices. First, they can choose for not help others. The second option is attack the plague right away, but risk his life. The fundamental contradictions that are found in human existence and the contradiction is the rebels. From a communicative perspective, plague epidemics can be thought of as rhetorical interruptions. Such incidents disrupt the typical patterns of daily life, providing opportunities as well as obstacles in everyday life. The absurd metaphor from both a phenomenological and a hermetic perspective.
Rebels and pleasure. The rebels were a challenge to the pro-communist orthodoxy of many leftists, including the influential intellectual led by Jean-Paul Sartre. By this time, Sartre had become sympathetic to communist values, while Camus had cultivated a growing antipathy of communists. Camus discussed limits, revolutions, freedom, and justice. As a screenwriter, Camus attempted to build a work of fiction on historical events and characters that represent the limit of the rebellion. Rebels are government-sanctioned killings or logical crimes. The rebels are divided into sections. 1. The rebels. 2. Metaphysical rebellions. These are absolute negations, denial of salvation, absolute affirmation and nihilism in history, and the last is historical rebellion.
OPM style manifests in propaganda or concert rebellion against NKRI. The Free Papua Movement organization OPM, which aims to separate from the unitary state of the Republic of Indonesia, NKRI, is carried out by all men so that it is considered a rebellion. The OPM maneuver used the Indonesian government to corner the government to attract international attention. The nature and foundation of human communication with the case of the Free Papua Movement OPM. Discussion related to the nature and foundation of human communication with the example of the Free Papua Organization OPM case that occurred in Indonesia are basically the process of forming, conveying, receiving, and processing message that take place within a person or between two or more with specific goals, but communication can also create propaganda in order to gain public support, the most prominent of which is a propaganda technique designed to trigger reflex condition in favor of the party or group in power. A clear oversimplification of the difference between propaganda and what is commonly referred to as persuasion. Conclusion. The conclusion from the whole of this material is that communication technology, like Zen, has such a level of complexity that it is possible for anyone to understand the totality of its principle and application. There are many ways in which these wholesome forms of government find public support, the most prominent of which is propaganda technique, designed to instigate revolt condition in favor of the ruling party, the Free Papua Organization OPM, spark propaganda the international community that the Indonesian state had committed human rights violations in Papua.
Okay, thanks for presentation. Sorry for our late. Thank you.